Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, read by Stig Weems. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. The Lenski Kids and Dracula. The Lenski kids could scare off any babysitter. Then Kim Kip came to live next door. Have the Lenski kids met their match at last? The Lenski Kids and Dracula by Libby Hathorn. The dedication reads, for Dorothy and Louie. Chapter 1. They were the wildest, meanest, screamiest kids you ever saw. The whole lot of them. Actually, there were only three, but it felt like a whole lot more. A herd of kids. There was Noel with the red hair that stood up in spikes all over his head. He had freckles and a wide mouth that turned down at the edges mostly, especially when he yelled, which was often. He was 10 and top dog. There was Samantha with browny red hair, straight as sticks, and a fringe that covered her eyebrows. She was as tall as Noel and nearly as tough, even though she was only 8. Little Craig had pink hair that fell in beautiful ringlets around his face and down his neck. He looked like an angel, but he hardly ever acted like one. He was 5 and could be downright dangerous. Oh, and there was Fury too, their dog, a great curly-headed mutt. He was playful and friendly, but when the going got rough, Fury had several secret places and could hide from the Lenski kids for hours on end. Fury was an extremely clever dog. Talk about noise. There were blood-curdling whoops and ear-piercing screams and elongated cries, but never, ever whispers when the Lenski kids were around. And talk about fights. There were kicks, punches, spits and scratches and arm-bending wrestles and never saying sorry when the Lenski kids were around. They were wild, all right. The wildest. The funny thing was that their parents were the nicest people ever. You wouldn't believe how nice Mr. and Mrs. Lenski were. Not wild at all. Polite, sweet, and utterly adoring of their three awful kids. Mr. and Mrs. Lenski looked alarmingly alike. Both were round and pale, with dreamy eyes and nervous smiles. Kids will be kids, Mr. Lenski would say when neighbours complained yet again about broken windows, or bikes, or legs, or something or other the Lenski kids had done. Unfortunately, he always added, a little sadly and with an apologetic smile, I'll have to speak to Noel Samantha Craig about your son-daughter's broken arm toy bike, he'd say in such a worried way. Oh dear, Mrs. Lenski would say in sympathy when some kid on the block showed her a bruise or a scratch or a black eye that a Lenski kid had delivered. How awful for you. And you say Noel Samantha Craig did that to you. Whatever for, you poor little child. They mean well, but they do get a little obstreperous at times, I'm afraid. You'll just have to learn to keep right out of their way. You had to feel sorry for the Lenski parents, all right. They had a lot to put up with. The Lenski house was in a quiet street. It was a big old place with an upstairs and rambly verandas, and it had a big, unruly garden. As you got closer to the front door, you realised it was a bit like a bomb site. Mess everywhere, and stacks of it. Mr. and Mrs. Lenski had wisely decided not to worry about tidying up until the children had grown up. What was the use? They asked one another. And of course, they were quite right. There was a tangle of toys, bikes, rollerblades and games from one end of the place to the other. Broken toys, bikes, rollerblades and games, naturally. And the kids' bedrooms, if you could get into them, not that you'd want to, were indescribable. But the Lenski backyard was the most interesting place of all. It was very tricky because the Lenski kids had rigged up trapdoors and other booby.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.